In this video, I'm going to show you how I rig, animate, and set up a game sprite with Live2D. You can find the PSD, Simo3, animation files, and the Unity project file in the link in the description so you can follow along. This video will mostly be a workflow video, but if you'd like to watch a more in-depth tutorial, I have a link to those videos in the description as well. So let's get started! So, with Live2D Cubism open, I've created a new project, and I'm just going to import my PSD file by dragging it into the workspace. And once it's imported, I'm going to press Ctrl+A to select all of the layers, and I'm going to create a standard auto mesh. And this is basically how I set up my CMO3. The first thing that I usually make is the eye blinking because it's fairly easy and quick to make. For this game sprite, I kind of wanted to keep it simple and also a little bit cartoony, so I made the eye blinking by creating two eye layers, a blinking eye layer and an open eye layer. And then on the blinking parameter, I just set the opacity to 0 or to 100% depending on the parameter value. So the blinking parameter that I'm using is IOPENL, and at 0, I'm going to set the opacity to the open eye layer to 0, and at 1, I'm going to set the opacity of the closed eye layer to 0. Because we're going to be creating a game sprite, we're going to be creating live movements that we can use for animation. I've created two new parameters for each limb, 8 parameters in total, and the minimum parameter value is going to be -1, and the maximum parameter value is going to be 1. General axis rules, as you're moving to the negative, it's going to be moving to the left, and as you're moving into the positive, it's going to be moving to the right. The topmost parameter is going to be moving the entire length of the limb. So for example, it's going to be moving the entire arm. And the second parameter is going to move the midpoint of the limb. So for example, that's the elbows, or if it's the leg, that's going to be the knees. And I'm just going to do that for every single limb. For the head and the body, I didn't want to make it too crazy, I kind of wanted to keep this model simple, so I just made everything move to the left and the right, so just a very simple tilting motion for the head and the body. If you're familiar with Live2D, then I'm sure you've seen the XY angle, so actually moving the head left and right in 3D space. But because this is just going to be a platformer sprite, I didn't really want to do that for this one. And this is just something that's going to be useful in animation. I'm also going to be creating two new parameters, and that's the position and the angle parameters. For the position, at 1, I'm just going to move her entire body up, and at -1, I'm going to move her entire body down. And for the angle parameters, I'm just gonna move it left and right, but not attach it to the body send. For things that I don't really want to manually animate because it's a bit of a hassle, I like to set them up as physics. So for example, what I'm setting up here is the hair. I'm creating that as a physics group in Live2D. Once again, I have the CMO3 downloadable in the link in the description, and I also have a video where I talk more in depth about physics setup, so I'm not really going to be explaining it that much here, but all I'm doing is I'm setting up the physics to move with the body and with the head. This is so that in the animations tab, when I've already created the head animations and the body animations, I can just bake physics and it'll automatically create the movement of the hair, and I don't have to manually make that myself. And now we're going to start animating. And we're going to start with the idle animation. For the idle animation, you can basically make whatever I want, but I'm gonna keep it simple and I'm going to make a 6-second idle animation where she's just breathing in and out. Something that you have to take note of is you have to keep the first and last frame the same, so it has to have the same parameter values, so that the looping is smooth. And what I like to do with that frame is I like to have her at a very neutral position. This is so that it keeps the transitions between like the walking or the jumping animations pretty smooth. Next, we're going to be creating the walk cycle. There are many ways to animate a walk cycle, but this is generally how I think about it. So in a walk cycle, we're going to move between these four states. And the only thing you have to remember is that the arms and the legs are alternating in their movements. So for example, when the right arm is moving forward, the right leg is moving backwards. And the animation that we're going to create is going to cycle between these states. Starting with the leg movement, I'm just going to make it so that the legs alternate back and forth. So when the right leg moves forward, the left leg moves back, and then vice versa. And then we're going to add in the arms. So, like the legs, the arms are going to move back and forth, but they're going to be inverse to the legs. So for example, your left leg moves forward, your left arm is going to move backward. And on the other side, your right leg moves backward, your right arm is going to move forward. So the jump animation is fairly simple to make. What we're going to do is we're going to select the position parameter that we created earlier, and we're just going to set it to 1, which is the highest point vertically. And then you can just adjust the pose to your preference. I like to have her tilted back a little and have her knees bent. This is just so that it looks a little bit nicer in the transition back to landing. And for completion's sake, I'm just going to create a very simple flopping over death animation. And now that we're done creating our animations, we're going to add some secondary movement to it by using bake physics. So what we're going to do is we're going to click animation, track, bake animation from physics, and we're going to select the physics group that we want in this animation. And I'm just going to select all of them. And we can manually adjust it if we want, but for me this looks good. And now I'm just going to do the exact same thing with the other animation. So I'm going to go to animation, track, and bake animation for physics for all of them, adjusting wherever necessary. And once you've done all of that, you're basically finished with your sprite, so export it for runtime, and then I'm going to show you how it looks like in Unity. So setup in Unity is pretty simple. Once you've installed the Cubism for Unity package, you can basically just drag and drop the folder that you created into the assets folder, and it'll automatically create a prefab, animation controller, and the animations. And once you're done with that, you can basically code it normally as an image or as animations. I have the link to this whole Unity project in the link below in the description, so you can check it out for yourself. But basically, I'm just using the .motion3 animations that we've created in Live2D as regular animations, and we're going to connect them in the same way you connect like sprite animations. And as you can see, she's moving, and she's moving with the animations. I haven't created any other assets for this Unity project, but you can see how it looks like and how it works with Live2D. It's pretty simple. Now, I'm not sure if you noticed earlier, but for some weird reason, her back arm wasn't moving, so I'm just going to show you how to update your animations. I've already created the brand new animations and exported them, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete the old .motion3 files, and I'm going to reinstall the new ones. And as you can see, the entire thing is updated. It's pretty useful if you want to change the look of the animation, or if you want to change something about the sprite. And it's pretty simple to update, so yeah. I hope you enjoyed this video, I hope that you learned something new, and if there's anything you want to know, any questions you have, or anything else you'd like to see, feel free to let me know in the comments below. Thank you for watching! この番組はご覧のスポンサーの提供でお送りしました。